Go off.
Okay, listen. First off, your the idea of how you look at the chart for alignment, I would say, is incorrect. First, you have lawful and chaotic. Lawful and chaotic is lawful is if you see the universe as having an order. Chaotic is if you see the universe as not having an order. Okay.
Okay.
Good and evil is if you are for if you are for everyone, you are good. If you are for yourself, you are evil. Okay.
Okay.
So if you look at the Joker, where does he fall? He believes that there is an order to the universe.
Okay.
Yep.
And he believes that that order is incorrect and it should be changed. Right?
Okay.
And he is doing what he can for everyone else to fix the order.
Okay.
He is lawful good.
Okay.
In his mind.
In his mind, he is lawful good.
Okay.
Now, Batman is also lawful good. Okay? Hmm. He believes that there is an order, and he believes that order is a real thing. The challenge between the Joker and Batman is actually which worldview is correct.
This makes a whole lot of sense to put them in the same alignment, because that sets up the tension.
Right. That's what they're fighting about. They're not fighting good and evil. The Joker doesn't necessarily care about getting stuff or having anything. He is trying to convince the world that the world you live in, your view of it is bad. Your view of the world is bad. Not that the world is bad,
right,
but your view of it is corrupted.
Right.
That's why he says when he's in the hospital, if you kill a truckload of soldiers, no one cries. But if you kill a puppy, oh my God, it's so bad. Because it's the plan. As he says, it's the plan. And as long as things are in the plan, everybody's okay with it. The plan is what's wrong.
Now, that's for the internalization of the character.
That's true.
Right. But when you take the character away from the internalization and you start bringing it, because, you know, as an actor, you know, internalization is one step, but now we have to present it how it comes out. And when he comes out, he is no longer lawful good.
Yeah.
Because now we have the perception of those of the world
or the audience,
how he is perceived. Mm. So there's kind of a dichotomy there. Is what is the internal? Do I play what's internal to the character? Do I play as the world will perceive the character?
Oh, that's true.
If that completely changes him, because from a world perception, he is chaotic evil because he's against the established rule of law, and he is out for himself.
Yeah, but wouldn't it be true that the established order is the problem? So if you're fighting the established order to make the world a better place, wouldn't that make you good? Internally, it's good, but isn't the external?
But good and evil are relative to the individual and the society. We look at for example, the Nazi society as an evil society, but within themselves, they perceive that they're bringing order and law to their world.
Yeah, this is true.
From their viewpoint, they were good. So it's a perception thing. And so there's that, you know, even though it talks about how the character sees the world, when you start playing with other characters, then it's how it really, by nature, changes into how are they going to perceive me?
Well, okay.
Because by your definition, everybody is lawful good. To themselves, because everybody perceives of what they're doing. You know, the worst villain in the world thinks what they're doing is justified and right.
That is true.
That makes for a good villain, for sure.
Right.
Like, if they don't have that motivation.
Okay.
Bye, everybody.
Bye. This is our outtakes. This is what happens afterwards. Okay. Bye, guys.
You guys, that was like...